Of the Civics Debates Battle Party System.
Brought to you by Asia United, the bank of choice. Shell, get the most out of every drop. The Malayan Insurance Company, insured to be sure. And ANC.
Good evening, welcome to Square Off the Civics Debates, where the most intrepid of our politicians venture onto our level playing field and dare to subject their plans and visions to the challenges of competing ideas. Tonight, two of them go head-to-head on the Philippines' political party system, which until 1987 was a two-party system. But after President Marcos made a mockery of this under the martial law dictatorship, the framers of our present constitution saw fit to institute a multi-party system to ensure no single party would hold power by itself. Now, many analysts blame the multi-party system for the chaotic state of Philippine politics, no more evident supposedly than in this election season. Our proposition tonight, let it be resolved that the Philippines should revive the two-party system. Our debaters for the affirmative side, Nacionalista Party senatorial candidate Adel Tamano. Good evening, Attorney Tamano.
Good evening. Good evening, sir.
For the negative side, senatorial candidate of the Liberal Party, Akbayan Representative Risa Hontiveros. Welcome, Congresswoman Risa.
Good evening, sir. Good evening.
We're using a modified Oregon-Oxford format. Each debater delivers a constructive speech no longer than 2.5 minutes in length in three areas: the proposition's necessity, beneficiality, and practicability. The opposite side then gets to ask one question pertaining to the topic, which the speaker has 1 minute and 30 seconds to answer. One question may be posed by each of the panelists during each speaker's turn. Additional time may be granted at the moderator's discretion. Finally, each speaker has 2 minutes for a closing statement. Introducing our panelists tonight, Attorney Ruth Oreta of the CVC Law Firm. Good evening. And we encourage you to participate in our live chat by logging on to www.abs-cbnnews.com/ANC Live Events using your Facebook or Twitter accounts. Now, let Battle Party System begin. For the affirmative side, arguing the necessity of reverting to the two-party system, Attorney Adel, you have 2.5 minutes, sir.
Thank you, Twink. Risa, good evening.
Good evening.
If the Philippines is to have a genuine democracy, it is necessary to adopt a two-party system. The heart of a democracy is a rule by the majority. And since the adoption of the 1987 Constitution, the Philippines has never had a majority president. Because our presidents are minority presidents, our politics have unfortunately become transactional, they have become elitist, and they have become personality-based. I'll give you three specific reasons why we have to revert to a two-party system. Number one, in a two-party system, there is a strong program of government, there is a stable administration and opposition relation, and there is a continuity of government affairs and government policies. A minority president, as has been the case since the 1987 Constitution, that cobbles together a so-called rainbow coalition, does not have a stable program of government, because internally, within the coalition, there is a constant desire to grab power. Equilibrium is seldom achieved in rainbow coalitions. By the time that one coalition ends, another coalition is being formed, and sometimes by the same parties with some additions, or perhaps it will be by a brand new coalition. With a new coalition, the programs become different, and no continuity is achieved, and therefore we have no clear platform of governance. Number two, a two-party system should be adopted because a two-party system is less prone to corruption and transactional and personality-based politics. It takes a lot of money, as we know, to run for public office, and sometimes candidates will have to solicit funds from businessmen and even gambling and drug lords. When elected, they become indebted. In a two-party system, each party can consolidate their funds for party candidates. The government can even subsidize the election expenses of two official parties, as is in the case of the United States. In sum, the two-party system promotes genuine democracy, it promotes accountability, decisiveness, and a continuity of policies based on an actual platform of governance. Thank you.
Congresswoman Risa, you may ask your questions in the area of the proposition's necessity.
Thank you, Twink, and also good evening, Adel. You said that the two-party system would enable us to evolve a political system that is less prone to corruption and to transactional politics. As a member of a party slate that claims to be the genuine opposition, don't you in fact see that the current administration, the Makapagal Arroyo administration, one of the worst children of the pre-1987 two-party system, is actually the epitome of corrupt and transactional politics, that it does not give way, in fact, to the participation of citizens and the accountability that they can exact from their public officials?
Thank you for that question. In fact, the GMA administration is a perfect example of the failure of the multi-party system, because the GMA administration is a rainbow coalition of people from different political parties who joined their organization after GMA was sworn into power. In fact, the fact that the GMA administration has been so corrupt is because of the transactional nature of a multi-party system. Since you do not have a strong party, in order to maintain the party loyalty of your so-called party members who merely joined your party just because you're in power, you have to pay them off. And I believe that, unfortunately, one of the strong reasons why we have to adopt a two-party system is to prevent another GMA. Because with a two-party system, then it is no longer personality-based, and people join parties on the basis of platforms.
Would you not rather agree, Adel, that the GMA administration has been one of the most resistant to the emergence of a genuine multi-party system? It has become the problem for the emergence, not only of the multi-party system, but the essential elements of the multi-party system. Genuine parties distinct from each other, contending in the field of ideas. It is a child of the two-party system. Its success would mean, in fact, a de facto return to the two-party system that you are advocating.
No, I cannot agree with you, Risa, because very clearly the GMA administration is a Frankenstein coalition of different parties. And it is precisely because of the multi-party system and the fact that we have not created a real, genuine institutionalization of the two-party system that we allow an administration like the GMA administration to occur.
Well, of course, I would continue to argue that the GMA administration is the perfect argument to continue to struggle for the emergence of a genuine multi-party system, because it does not represent it at all. It is, in fact, a champion of a return to the two-party system. Unfortunately, that seems to be your proposition tonight as well.
Anyway, we have a question from Attorney Ruth.
Attorney Adel, you mentioned earlier that a two-party system will prevent further conflicting interests from arising because there will be no more coalitions. However, in the current political system, in our current political system, there are various interests that are being represented by various sectors. And do you think a single dominant party can accommodate all these conflicting interests and prevent their members from asserting other interests?
I think, in fact, we're having perhaps a little problem in terms of ideas. I think what Risa was saying was that there is a single dominant party, and that is the GMA Frankenstein coalition. Mm-hmm. And it seems she's using it as an argument against the two-party system. But that's a problem. In fact, a two-party system, let's use the best example, the United States, the Democrats and the Republicans. It cannot be a single dominant minority system, a single dominant party system. It's always two nearly equal parties. And that is how we have that system of checks and balances. One does not dominate another. Because if you have a dominant party, then that's no longer a two-party system. And in fact, the reason why we have a GMA administration is because of the multi-party system, and because we don't have a real fair two-party system where two nearly equal bodies, you know, they compete in the realm of ideas. I would have to say that just like in the United States, each party, the Republicans and the Democrats, they have sufficient democratic space for the different sectors to join whichever party that they like.